In today's video, I am going to explain important biomechanics of ankle joint. First thing first, I wanna explain three bones first. First one is this one. This is talus, okay? This one is talus. Next one is this one. This is tibia. Third one, this is fibula. Talus, tibia, and fibula. This relationship is very important to understand ankle joint mechanics. And I want to explain two ankle movements. This is dorsiflexion. Okay, dorsiflexion. Dorsiflexion is like you point toes up movement. Dorsiflexion. The other way is plantar flexion. Plantar flexion is like toe reaching this way. Okay, dorsiflexion and plantar flexion. To accomplish dorsiflexion and plantar flexion, flexibility of ankle muscles are so important, such as gastrocnemius, calf muscle, tibialis anterior, that is on anterior part. Tightness and flexibility are important for ankle joint movement, but not only that. If you look detail of ankle movement mechanics, in dorsiflexion, this tibia and fibula slightly open up, just tiny bit, not this big, this is just visualization. Dorsiflexion, tibia and fibula need to open up, just tiny bit, okay? So if tibia and fibula do not open up, that inhibit movement of dorsiflexion. Does it make sense? I repeat that again. During dorsiflexion, tibia and fibula must open up, okay? Dorsiflexion, tibia, fibula open up. If tibia and fibula do not open up, that may inhibit movement of dorsiflexion. Let's see, if I squish tibia and fibula, maybe dorsiflexion is hard to do. That makes sense. Then one more structure. Between tibia and fibula, there is one membrane, that is interosseous membrane. Imagine there's tibia above this and fibula above this. And interosseous membrane connects tibia and fibula. What if this membrane is tight, get shortened? That kind of brings tibia and fibula this way, then what's gonna happen? There's no space for opening up. Then what's gonna happen for dorsiflexion? It's limited, it is restricted. Thus, interosseous membrane, flexibility of interosseous membrane is important for ankle movement. Then I wanna add one more thing. Interosseous membrane actually has muscle attachment. What does it mean? Some muscles attach to interosseous membrane. If you look at anatomy books, yes, some muscles attach to interosseous membrane. What kind of muscles are there? Let's say tibialis posterior, that is on posterior part. Tibialis posterior, flexor hallucis longus, that kind of curls big toe. Tibialis posterior, flexor hallucis longus, tibialis anterior, that is on anterior part. Extensor hallucis longus, extensor digitorum longus. Many muscles attach to interosseous membrane. Then what's gonna happen if these muscles get tight? Maybe that tightens up interosseous membrane. Tight interosseous membrane may bring tibia and fibula together. Then there's no space for opening up tibia fibula. What's gonna happen? Maybe dorsiflexion is restricted. Thus, flexibility of lower extremity muscles and flexibility of interosseous membrane is crucial for ankle movement. You know, this is kind of advanced mechanics, advanced biomechanics of ankle joint. But if you know today's anatomy, you can apply for so many things. Maybe you can apply for running, maybe you can apply for athletic movement, maybe you can apply for clinical experience. I hope today's anatomy helps your career. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.